Hi, this is Josh Ellsworth with Stahl's CAD-CUT Direct, and we want to give you a tutorial all about creating animal patterns in CadworxLIVE.com. A while back, we did a video that showed you exactly how to heat apply our CAD-CUT line of heat transfer films to create really nice looking effects in the form of animal prints onto apparel with text-based graphics. Since then, we've had a lot of questions on how exactly to set up and create artwork for this process, so we'd like to spend this time to show you how. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you three ways to create animal prints, three different techniques that you need to know depending on the look you want or the material you're working with. In any case, we're going to start with just some basic text on the screen. When creating animal prints, I recommend selecting a fatter or bold font, so it shows more of the print throughout. Also recommend using a pretty decent sized letter. In this case, I'm going to size up to 4 inches. And then just so I can fully demonstrate the different effects, I'm going to add a outline effect or a contour around this design. These are all functions that are readily available in CadworxLIVE.com, which is a online design software for Stahl's customers. Let me change the color of that background so we can easily identify it. Let's just make it pink. And I'll click OK, and it'll generate that on the screen. I'm going to make 3 copies so I can show you the 3 effects. First, let me break it apart by color so I can separate those out. And before I make the multiple copies, let me add my animal print to the page. Within CadworxLIVE.com, there's a stock zebra print that I'll use for this demonstration. You can bring in any piece of artwork or print as long as it's a vector format into CadWorx. If it's not a vector format, you can click on File, Import, and Vectorize to make it vector. But for this case, we'll just pick a standard zebra clip art by searching the word zebra and dropping this block zebra print onto the page. At this point, it's critical to size the block to the stripe size that you want for applying within the text. In this case, it probably wouldn't look good if I made this really large to fit all the text. I wouldn't be able to make out the exact lettering. So what I'm going to try to do is make it so it covers these 2 letters. And then I'm going to go to Edit and duplicate it, and then use a second block to accommodate the H and the S. After I line that up, you can see the seam is down in between the letters. That way you're not seeing the seam in the print. You can make your gap spacing in between letters a little larger in the text setup as well, or you can zoom in to make sure you do that correctly. But I'm going to hold the Shift key. I'm selecting both zebra blocks, and I need to make sure that those are grouped together. So I'll hit the condense button. And now when I select it, it selects both pieces together. Okay, at this point, I'm going to draw a box around everything and make my multiple copies because I have everything set up for what I want to demonstrate. So duplicate, there's a second copy. Let's duplicate again. That's going to give my 3rd copy to show the 3 techniques. The first step is consistent across all 3 methods, which is selecting the zebra background prints that we've grouped in the text, either by drawing a box or selecting each individually and holding the Shift key on the keyboard. But once you select them, you need to go to the shaping. And depending on the order that you've placed them on the screen, you'll either do front minus back or back minus front as the command. What I'm going to do is we'll start with the back minus front. Try that and make sure that's the right command. And now when I drag that away, you can see I have my animal print. So I'm going to actually delete the pattern that's selected by clicking the delete button on the keyboard. And then I'm going to select my other 2 images. Once again, I just go to shaping, back minus front. Drag away the blocks and delete. Select my last set, shaping, back minus front. Drag this away and delete. So now, if you want to do the direct overlap technique, which would be for heat transfer films that are recommended for layering, you would basically be done. You're ready to cut the AGHS background out of whatever CAD-CUT material you want, and the zebra print foreground over out of a different color of CAD-CUT material. You can see when you drop it on top of the AGHS, that contour gives us a nice little bit of an outline around the edge, which is great for placing it and aligning everything. So we get a pink zebra print text, in this case, ready to cut both layers. Now, if you want to do a method that I like to call the show-through technique, so basically you're only utilizing one color of heat transfer film, I'm going to drop this over the top again, but now instead of just cutting it like this, I can send all cut lines together at once to the material I want, but I'd rather select it, and I'm going to go up to the shaping tool and use the combine feature. And the combine is basically going to combine those two colors together and punch out the zebra print cut lines from the background. So you click combine, and you can see when you cut this, now I'm going to have to take the weeding tool and pick out all of these pieces, which, you know, is going to be a little bit more labor on your part for weeding, but you're only using one color of heat transfer film, so you're decreasing your material cost. I personally would prefer to show a two-color result, because the weeding on this, if I drag it apart again, is a piece of cake. When I go to weed this edge, all of these inside pieces come out. I don't need to start and stop with the weeding tool to pick out all the centers. Okay, so we have the layer on layer method on top. That's number one. We have the show through method on number two. And the last method is the trapping method, which is recommended for materials that do not layer. Now, for the trapping method, basically what you have to do is you need to create a contour onto the pattern. So you need to create a contour to the inside of the pattern. So I will double click on the pattern while I have it selected, and that's going to bring up my editor. And I'm simply going to go to the Add Effect button within CadWorx, back to the contour command, select the basic contour, which is this visual here, the basic outline. We don't want a gap outline or anything, just the basic contour outline. Open that. You'll notice that contour defaults to the outside if I change the color. Let's just make it gold. You can see how it did a contour clear around the outside of my design. For the trapping method, you want to do a contour to the inside. So all I did is uncheck the outside button. I'm going to check the inside button. Now, depending on your the size of your design, you need to change the offset. You basically just want a small offset so the materials are overlapping slightly for registration. When you heat apply this to the garment, this is so that the garment color doesn't show through and it looks like it's off of registration. So in this case, I'm going to try a 0.03, and you can see how it's a much thinner offset, and I'm going to click OK. Now I'm going to select this pattern again, and I'm going to break it apart by colors by going up to shaping, break apart by colors. Now if I select my yellow layer here and drag it off of the black layer, I can actually drop my yellow within the AGHS. Remember the combine feature we did through the show through? We're going to do the same thing here. I'm going to select the yellow and the pink, which is going to serve as my background layer. I'm going to go to shaping and combine, which basically punched out weeding areas for garment show through. It looks a lot like this one, but you'll notice that these areas are intentionally created to be weeded out so that when you overlay the foreground, it's going to drop right inside of those areas with a little bit of an overlap. So I actually cut the pink layer and heat press it down first, and then I'm going to, while that's selected, I'm going to go up to align and bring this to the front so you can visualize it. And when you go to heat press this on top, you'll see there's no show through at all when you perfectly register it. There's going to be a little bit of an offset there that will allow a slight overlap in your registration, but really it's going to be a perfect trapped result and a two-color full glitter animal print if we use the glitter flake material, which is one of the most popular materials for this technique. So ultimately, there's a little bit more labor once again in weeding out these centers, and you have to do two colors, but the finished result for a two color zebra print glitter is top notch. This has been a tutorial all about creating patterns for animal prints out of CAD-CUT materials utilizing CadworxLIVE.com. To sign up for a free 30-day demo of CadworxLIVE.com, just visit the website CadworxLIVE.com, or to purchase heat transfer films factory direct, visit CADCUTDirect.com.